So what's up everyone, welcome back to a crazy tutorial where we're gonna create asteroid falling down from the sky, and we're gonna use EV engine to create this animation. And it's pretty easy to create this animation, and we're gonna use few shaders trick to create this animation. No geometry nodes, nothing difficult, everything will be really good and really easy. If you guys need the project file, get it on Patreon, or you can get it on Gumroad for $1. And let's get started. So clear out everything from scene, press A and delete everything, shift A, add a cube, and I'm gonna go to modifiers, add a subdivision modifier, subdivision surface. I'm gonna add 8 in it. You can add how much ever you want. The more you add the subdivision, the more detail you're gonna get. So I'm gonna right click and shade smooth. And now I'm gonna add one more modifier called displace modifier. I'm gonna click on new, click on these buttons and clouds. And now I'm gonna give size of 1 and increase the detail or depth to 6 or 7. You can add however you want. And I'm gonna go back to modifier, decrease the strength of the object to 7.750. I'm gonna save the file so I won't lose it. I saved the file. Now let's get in shaders and add some really cool shaders. And click on new, shift A, add a color ramp, add a noise texture, and press Ctrl T if you have a node wrangler enabled in add-ons. Ctrl T and you'll see 2 more nodes are added into the scene. And I'm gonna grab the object and plug it in vector. I'm gonna move these nodes away. I'm gonna plug this color into factor, and now I'm gonna plug this color ramp into emission strength. Now I'm gonna add a math node, and I'm gonna plug it in over here. And now I'm gonna go to EV engine and see what's happening over there. I'm gonna go to render view, and I'm gonna turn my wall black. Decrease the scale of noise texture to 3 and increase the detail to 12 and increase the roughness a little bit more. And now I'm gonna click on this emission and turn from black to kind of blue. Or you can do it however you want, because we're gonna change all of these colors later, and I'm just doing it for so we can see what's happening behind you. I'm gonna take this black portion and take this white portion. So I'm gonna add a sun, light, sun, and rotate it over there. Press R twice and rotate it. You can adjust the setting however you want, and I'm gonna increase the strength to 4. Click on the asteroid back, and I'm gonna duplicate this node and change it to minimum. Take this color ramp, plug it in to value, and add one more node, duplicate this node, and I'm gonna change it to logarithm and plug this value into base. Take this wire and put it in the top one and plug this value into add, and I'm gonna change this from add to multiply. And now I'm gonna add one more multiplier, 50, and plug it over there. And I'm gonna change this value from 500.5 to 0.999. Also in logarithm 0.999, change this value to 175 maybe. And when you take this black portion and move it, and you can see the light is increasing. I'm gonna move it over there. Now we're gonna change few lights, add a color ramp, add a noise texture, and plug this mapping node into the vector of noise texture, and add a bump node. and plug this factor into factor, and plug this factor into bump, and plug it in height, and take the bump and plug it in the normal, and I'm gonna decrease the scale to 1.3 and increase the detail to kind of 15 or maybe 12, maybe increase the roughness to 600. And now I'm gonna change the strength to 0.4 and distance to 0.8. I'm gonna save the file. And now it's time for adding new colors. Take this color ramp, the color ramp that we just created for the lights. Take this color ramp and plug it in emission. And you can see things are changed. And click on this black portion, increase the brightness and make it kind of blue, and take this black portion and make it kind of red. Now I'm going to change from linear to constant, add one more color, and I'm going to make it yellow. And now you can see some really cool things are happening. I'm gonna take this red portion and move it so we can barely see the lights, and you can also adjust the settings however you want. I'm gonna add a camera, if they add a camera, move it over there and control alt and zero. And now I'm gonna create those red and blue lights that were flashing or maybe going front and back. I'm gonna create those lights. I'm gonna shift A, add a cylinder, right click, show smooth, and now I'm gonna rotate the cylinder over there, I think, and I'm gonna change from global to local so I can scale it and move it. Really cool. I'm gonna scale it, and now I'm gonna add a shader to the cylinder, add a noise texture, add a color ramp, and I'm gonna press Ctrl T on the noise texture and plug the color into factor and the color in emission. I'm gonna change from generated to object. Take the object and plug it in my vector. And now I'm gonna go to the Uber shading, and now I'm gonna go to this material tab and click on settings from opaque to alpha blend, and click on shadow mode from opaque to none. I'm gonna decrease the alpha so I can barely see those lines. I'm gonna take this black portion over there, and I'm gonna scale down the Z axis, so over there, and I'm gonna increase the strength and decrease the alpha. And also you can decrease the Y scale, so if you need the thicker lines you can decrease the scale, and if you need the thinner lines you can increase it. I'm gonna increase and take this black portion, and now I'm gonna animate these lights. Click on the white portion and change it from white to red. Grab one more window, timeline, and I'm gonna animate the location, and I'm gonna hover my mouse to the X axis, and I'm gonna click on I, and now I'm gonna go to end frame and make it kind of 700 maybe, and click on I again, so you can see it will be animating. Increase a little more black. I'm gonna increase the black portion a little more, and I'm gonna decrease the lines, increase the detail. I'm gonna decrease the Z axis. Now I'm gonna adjust these settings by myself and click on and press space and see how it's looking. I'm gonna increase alpha a little bit. And yeah, that's really cool. And I'm gonna shift D and duplicate the cylinder. Click on Z and R so we can rotate it by Z axis. And I'm gonna click on this tool button so we can separately change the shader. I'm gonna click on the red portion and change it to blue. And now you're gonna see the magic. Now I'm gonna add stars, and it's a really good trick to create stars. I'm gonna change from local to global, rotate it with RY90 and move it with X, scale it up a little more so we can fit in the camera. Click on new, delete the principal BSDF, add a Warner texture, Control T, move them away. I'm gonna add a color ramp, and I'm gonna add a matte node and plug the distance into value and color into value, and grab this value and plug it in color ramp and take the color into surface. Now I'm gonna go to the shader window back, and now I'm gonna increase the scale to maybe 120. I'm gonna take this black portion and take this white portion and reverse them. I'm gonna increase the scale to maybe 200. Now I'm gonna change the texture coordinate from generated to UV. Grab the UV and plug it in vector. And grab the black portion so we can barely see that. I'm actually gonna take this four cylinder and scale them up kind of over there. Now I'm gonna take the cube, animate the cube. Go to this yellow icon and press I on the rotation. Go to end, make the x-axis minus 360. Maybe it is 360 for you, but for me it's minus 360. And now you can see our asteroid is rotating. I'm actually gonna change the camera view from here to maybe over there. And now I'm gonna add some more detail to it, and I'm gonna add a plane. Scale it up, go to tab. You can add this detail if you want, but it's fine without that. Subdivide it with 100. And I'm gonna go to sculpt mode and grab this one over there and right click and increase the radius. Now I'm gonna adjust this setting and make it look like what I want. And I made this model, and now I'm gonna move this over there and scale it down so I can see that. I'm gonna go to EV window and rotate it down. I'm gonna move it over there, scale it up, and kind of like that. I'm gonna click on this cylinder, go to a shader editor, and copy all these nodes, Control C, click on the plane again, and create new material, and paste the node that we just copied, and plug the color into emission. And I'm gonna change from global to local and scale it with kind of like that. I'm gonna rotate it, and now I'm gonna decrease the alpha and go to material settings. Click on settings, from opaque to alpha blend, from opaque to none, and alpha down. And now I'm gonna take the red portion change it to white and decrease the black portion, and you can see something very cool happening. I'm gonna increase the emission strength to 100 maybe, and increase the black portion. I'm gonna adjust these settings. And now I'm gonna animate this too. Click I, go to the end frame, and maybe 7 to 800 maybe. And I'm gonna play the animation. I'm gonna scale it a little more. I'm gonna decrease the alpha, or maybe increase the black portion. And I'm gonna increase the Y portion. And that's really good for me. Contrast to high contrast. Okay, so really sorry about the camera. I think got some bugs or something. So what were we talking about? Click on this cube, Shift D, and move it away and scale it down. And Shift D again, move it over there, scale it down a little more. And Shift D, move it over there, scale it a little more. Kind of like that. And now I'm gonna play animation and see how they're looking. You can change all of these animation from there and make it look different. So I'm gonna add a little shake effect to my camera so I will get a little realistic animation. I'm gonna click on this camera icon. I got this add-on from Google for free. You can also get this add-on for free called Camera Shakeify. You can add it from edit and preferences and go to add-ons and install the add-on and check the mark. Now I'm gonna click on plus, decrease the influence maybe over there, and change from investigation to spaceship, increase the scale to 3. I'm gonna play animation. Now I'm gonna show you my output setting. Here you can see I already did some things over there, and I'm using 1920 by 1080p resolution. And I changed the FPS from 24 to 30 FPS. And you can select the file path where you want to save the animation or anything else. And select for the file format to FFmpeg if you need the full ready video. And I chose the container to MPEG-4 and output quality to a little bit high. So as you can see, we just created this project in just few minutes. And if you guys learned something from this video, make sure to give the thumbs up and make sure to subscribe to the channel so you guys will not miss any video and you guys will keep learning Blender. Again, if you need the project file, get it on Patreon or Gumroad, link will be in description down below. And comment down below if you guys have any idea what you recreate next, or maybe any other question or any other thing or any feedback on the video. Please comment down below, and so I will get motivated and keep making the videos. So that's all for today's video, and I'll see you in the next video.